Welcome to the Daily Mat. Today's episode is sponsored in part by Highland Woodworking. Visit their website at highlandwoodworking.com. And also by Lee Valley and Veritas. Visit their website at leevalley.com.
Next on our journey is our medium tools, and that's where the jointers come in. These are gonna take all those little hills and valleys that we've knocked down, but yet they're still slightly there. They've gone from deep valleys to little ditches, and now we wanna start, smoothing those out, and that's where the likes of the jointer come in. And this would pretty much be anything from technically a 7, 8, although you could easily throw a number 6 in there. And this is my number 7. And I happen to have this great this great joint right here. This is along the lines of a number 8. It's much longer, as you can see, than the number 7. I love using wooden planes. I've talked about it before. You get a real feel from the wood, literally. So we'll go ahead and we'll put those. So again, we have our rough tools. We have our medium tools. And then now we're going to move on to our fine tools. And that's where the likes of a number 4 come in, and these are our smoothers. And you can use a number 4, which is this traditional one right here. There's a number 4.5, which is this guy right here. And if you'll notice, the 4 and 4.5, it's the 4.5 is just a little bit longer. I know I probably should put the picture a little bit different there. The only thing really different about it is the 4.5, a little bit longer, a little bit wider, and I like using my 4.5 as my absolute finish on this because it's nice and heavy, so I can make sure that I can hold it down really easy and get a much better result from it. But to be honest with you, I grab my number 4 constantly and often will just use that as the final finish. Again, I'm getting ahead of myself here. I gotta stop doing that. Along the lines of the smoother, of course, you can get a bevel up smoother, which we have yet to really try this one out in the shop. It came in just before the holidays, and I should have taken some time to really set it up. Maybe we'll do that. We'll do an episode where we kind of set this up and get it going. And so one last one, which I think, in all honesty, some people would put this in the coarse area. Some people will put it in the fine area. Heck, you can put it in the medium, and that's what I do. This is my go-between everything, and this is always my go-for tool, and that, of course, is the block plane. And these come in standard angle, they come in low angle, and they typically don't come with this very large knob up here on the front, but that comes with an accessory that I bought for it, and I love having that knob that I can really push down and use a lot easier. But hey, that's a whole other episode too. So anyways, that's the introduction to the bench planes. Let me kind of get my head out of the way here a little bit. And hopefully that kind of answers your question about how you would use it. Again, we have the coarse, the mediums, and the fines. Don't use the numbering system for how you would use these tools because, like I said, if you started with one, you're working backwards. And on top of it, you'd probably damage it if you're trying to use that on some coarse material. So let's talk a little bit more about the bench planes in the next episode, and we'll go from there. See you later.
Thanks for watching. For more information on today's episode, visit mattsbasementworkshop.com. And a huge thanks to our sponsors, Highland Woodworking and Lee Valley. Visit them today.